All right, thanks everybody for joining me today. My name is Jimmy Rabin. I'm the Fortify product manager. And today we're gonna take a look at the IntelliJ SCA plugin. I will spend a little bit of time talking about some of the differences in a few of the different plugins we have available for IntelliJ. But this is the full scanning Fortify static code analyzer plugin that we'll be demonstrating today. So in IntelliJ, to install the plugin, you simply come to IntelliJ and Preferences. And once you are there, you can go to Plugins and say Install Plugin from Disk. And we do distribute the plugin with Fortify SCA and Apps. So if you look in the Plugins folder, once you've installed Fortify SCA and Apps, if you look in the Plugins directory, you will see the IntelliJ Analysis plugin. That is a full scanning plugin that we're going to be demonstrating today. We do also offer what we call a remediation plugin, which is an API-based plugin that connects to Software Security Center and allows you to view results in IntelliJ. And that is distributed outside of the SCA and Analyzers application. When you download the zip for SCA Analyzers and Apps, you'll see the remediation plugin is actually at the same level as the Fortify SCA installer. So you can install that one as well if you want an API-based experience. That won't let you scan, but it will let you look at results from Software Security Center that had already been scanned. So you can kind of decide that. We also do have a Fortify On Demand plugin, which is our SaaS platform, our as-a-service static and dynamic testing service, which allows you to package up code and send it to Fortify On Demand for review, and also to view the results back once they've been returned to you. But today, we'll be going through the Fortify Analysis plugin, which is the plugin designed to use locally with the on-premise tools to run Fortify SCA scans. Okay, so what we do, I just downloaded the IntelliJ's sample here to have a sample project. You can very easily here see the Fortify menu, analyze project, advanced scan, upload results, and analysis settings are all available to you for the analysis plugin that we're covering today. You can see the options for Fortify On Demand, and you can see the options down here for the remediation plugin since I have all three installed, but we're focusing on the analysis plugin today. So I'm just going to choose analyze project. And you'll see here in the bottom that we've begun the translation phase of SCA automatically. We are translating all of those files into an intermediary format, and then we're going to run the SCA analyzers to find any potential vulnerabilities in this application. While we're waiting for that to finish, let's take a look at some of the options. You do have the ability to configure both the translation and analysis phases. You can provide additional memory to the maximum Java heap if you have a very large scan you'd like to perform from your IDE. You can choose different rule packs if you'd like to create custom rules and include those. You can do that here. If you're on, you know, in terms of whether you're using T-SQL or PL-SQL, you can choose those options. You also have the ability to specify any advanced options in the translation and scanning phase here on the top and bottom. So we could use additional arguments and type things like, you know, dash debug, right, dash verbose, dash log file, sum.log, so that we could add additional parameters. So anything you can do with the SCA command line, you could do here. And we also have the ability to then upload the project once it's complete to Software Security Center. So this would be your Software Security Center login. That's the portal where we upload results and track issues to closure and have dashboarding and reporting. And we can upload that directly from here. So what we can see is the scan did finish. It did go ahead and upload that to Software Security Center because I had SSC configured. It was available at localhost 8080. So it did upload that. And we are simply, and also what happens is we store a copy locally. So you're also, the FPR is saved locally and optionally uploaded to Software Security Center. Now, unlike some of our other plugins, and you can see it was just succeeded there. So it has uploaded the latest scan to SSC. We'll take a look at it in a second. But you can actually view the results of the Fortify project report in IntelliJ. That's one unique distinction with the IntelliJ plugin. You can run a scan, you can configure it, you can upload the results, but you don't view the FPR inside of the IDE. Instead, you're given the location of where this FPR is located, and you open that with Audit Workbench, which is our Eclipse-based tool for viewing scan results locally. Or you can simply go to Software Security Center, which is what I've done here, and we can take a look at the IntelliJ sample, and we can see that if we look in the Artifacts tab after the we can see here we have 317 issues, 308 lows, 9 highs. We can take a look at any of these issues and begin the triage process in SSC. Or as I mentioned, we can just go to that location on the file system and save the FPR and open it using Audit Workbench. So that is the IntelliJ SCA plugin in a nutshell, pretty straightforward. Hopefully you found this video helpful, and look forward to talking to you again.